Dynamics 365 for Operations, running on Microsoft Azure as Software as a Service, provides code deployment capabilities on production environments. The capabilities are enabled by using Lifecycle Services, also known as LCS. In this video, we'll look at the process for deploying code to a production environment. One of the prerequisites for deploying code to a production environment is to make sure the deployable package is first tested on a sandbox environment. The deployable package must be marked as a release candidate in the asset library. Only release candidates can be deployed to production environments. After a release candidate has been identified, go to the production environment's detail page. Click Maintain, and then click Apply Updates. You will be presented with a list of release candidates that are available to be deployed to production. Select the one that must be deployed. You can schedule the deployment by providing the downtime start and end times. The system defaults the start time based on the minimum lead time required. You can change the start time to prolong the deployment start, but you can't make it start sooner than the minimum lead time. The system also defaults the end time based on the maximum expected downtime. You can change the end time to provide a longer window for downtime, but you can't make it shorter than the maximum expected downtime. Confirm the schedule to proceed. The system now confirms the expected downtime for the package deployment. Click Yes to submit the request. The request is now submitted. The environment page now shows the request. You can view the status of the request on this page. Until the deployment starts, you will be able to reschedule if needed. You can also change the package that must be deployed. If you want to cancel the deployment request, you can, but you must do so before the deployment starts. The comments section can be used to communicate with Microsoft. Microsoft also uses this section to communicate with you. After the package deployment has started, you can monitor the progress on this page. After the package has been deployed, you should perform tests to make sure it was successful. If the validations are positive, you can close the servicing request as signed off. If you're not satisfied with the results, you can close the servicing request as having issues. You must then follow up with Microsoft by opening a new support case for further investigation. You can view the history of deployments on the environment by clicking the History tab on the Environment page. This brings us to the end of this presentation. We hope you found the information useful. Thank you for watching.